2015 Northern Football League season. The umpire holds the ball aloft. And 2015 is underway for the NFL. The opening bounce goes the way of Greensborough. Hooper taps it down, and they're already going towards the forward 50. Across half forward, just still inside the centre square, the ball hits the deck. Eltham players gather around, and the umpire will have a secondary ball up, about 60 metres out from the Greensborough's goal. Kicking towards the near side of the ground, towards the club rooms. Glasgow comes through, gets hands to the footy. The umpire says we'll have a third ball up, just forward of the centre square. A
couple of big tackles to start things off there.
A lot of people gathering around the goals on the near side of the ground. Fowler's in there, gets the kick towards half forward, but it's been smothered. Now the ball goes up in the air, comes straight back down, coming through his Hyde. Tries to get the hands to the footy, laying a big tackle out there, looks like it was Clark. Hyde gets it again on half back, a big handball over the top, a sweeping handball, finds Josh Riddle. We're in the number 24 this year, Josh Riddle. He's taken to ground. I think the ball might have gone out of play. There'll be a ball up on the outer side.
Good pressure from this young Eltham side early. A couple of big tackles laid. Offhand, it was Lockie Richardson coming out of the stoppage. Now quick kick forward here for the Panthers. Kruthoratis almost pulled down the mark. At ground level, he's able to keep his feet. Sockers it off the ground in front of himself. Could he do something magical? Bodies crashing everywhere. Riddle went in really hard. And now a lot of numbers all over the footy. Deep in the Eltham forward half, it'll be a stoppage.
That clearance came from Billy Glasgow rather. Hard to believe he's only 20 years old. Such a big body in that midfield.
Now, out of the stoppage, a quick snap around the corner from Braden Taglieri. He was in a tight space there to get that kick away. He was able to get it away, but not accurately. Off to the right for one behind.
So the first score of the afternoon goes to Eltham. 90 seconds into the game. Eltham leading just by the one behind. Matty Hyde takes the kick out here for Greensborough. Long out to the near side. McClendon flies. Gets hands to the footy first, but couldn't control it. Kalai on hands and knees, gets the footy, handballs over the top to no one in particular, just wanted to dispose of it. Eltham players coming in, and we'll have a ball up.
Interesting with McClendon, he's been overseas for a great portion of the pre-season. It landed back in Melbourne yesterday, and he's straight back in the senior side.
Ball thrown up on centre wing, out of sight of the ground. Kalai in there again. Captain Lockie McCulkin wraps his man up in the tackle, and looks like there's going to be a free kick now.
He's given away the free to Taglieri.
So the skipper, the new skipper coming in this year for Eltham, Taglieri has it. Just on the corner of the centre square, at right half forward. On the right boot, goes along towards the goal square. Who can fly here?
Oh,
almost a mark taken in the goal square.
It's actually been paid there, the whistle's been blown.
Williamson, I thought he had enough of that.
And it's an interesting one, that the forwards are getting their hands on it early. Had that for probably just long enough. Earlier, Kruthoratis against two players as well. So they're getting enough supply early on, and without doubt, they're going to register the first goal of the 2015 season through Matt Williamson.
So Williamson lines up from 15 metres out. Oh, he just squeezed it in. It just shanked off to the right a little bit. I was a bit hesitant to call it a goal, but it's just squeezed in.
He made it tough for the umpire, but he got
there. So Eltham have the first goal of the afternoon. It is 1-1-7 to the Panthers. Greensborough yet to score, yet to go inside forward 50.
So Williamson with the first goal of the 2015 NFL season. It is Eltham 1-1-7, Greensborough yet to score. Eltham winning all that ball from the midfield, aren't they? We've seen Glasgow get his hands on it. Taglieri got the free kick in that situation. So Greensborough probably just needing to tighten up on a few of those key players for the Panthers.
They've had a fantastic intensity about them in these opening minutes here. Great tackling pressure and working really hard at the stoppages against some of these older, more experienced Greensborough bodies, really holding their own as DiPaolo goes up and wins it down, and a couple of players kick it into each other. A lot of numbers around the ball here at the moment. Quick kick forward is going to land in the arms of the man in woods. He's able to pick it up, but he was stopped straight away in his tracks. Now McQuilkin got it from Callaway and released a teammate halfback. Long high ball in the direction of Josh Riddle. Couldn't clunk it on the second grab. Good one-on-one defence by Lockie Richardson, and Ricky Mullins takes it out in front of the interchange gates.
The one thing you know you get out of Josh Riddle is that hard attack on the football. Goes at it like a bull at a gate, and that time there ran under a fraction, but he'll certainly give a good contest all day and all season long.
So the ball thrown in near side of the ground. The handball comes out to McQuilkin, who just hacks it onto the left and goes inside forward 50. Their first entrance of the day. Boyd came out to meet it, just got a little tap away. Callaway now handballs off to Riddle. Coming through is Josh Riddle, on to the left, grubbers one towards goal, meeting it in the goal square and around the body. was Stanton from the goal square, and Greensborough have their first goal of the day.
Well, it's their first foray forward, isn't it? And it looked pretty potent there. Josh Riddle attacked the ball. Cameron Jordan looked lively around the goal face there, and Stanton and Borden just managed to get to the back of the pack and get that easy ball there. Stanton snapping a goal. I thought he actually played his best game for the season last year on grand final day. Kicked a couple of goals, and he'll obviously be looking to bring that form into 2015 now that they don't have big Tim Bongetti beside him.
So the restart of play from the middle. Atkins doing the ruck work early, yet to sight Hooper in this one. Taps down to McQuilkin, who gets the clearance off the back of the circle. Again, hacks a left boot inside the forward 50. Coming out, meeting a hand to it was Josh Riddle. Couldn't control it. Exiting out of defence was Reed for Eltham. He goes long into the centre circles. Coming through there, Billy Glasgow. Again, another big kick inside forward 50. Coast to coast. Chris Aratus out to meet it. Doesn't take it. Drops it at the last second when he slid on his knees at the back. They still have possession here through Laurie. I think the whistle's gone.
Throw, I think it was.
And we'll see a free kick after all that going the way of Greensborough. This is looks like it's Atkins off half back, taking two bounces and handballing forward. McQuilkin, who's seen a lot of the footy early, handballs out wide, doing a nice little dance in midfield. They get out now to the right half forward flank. Out here is Nick Riddle, who's pushed up a long way, just tries to keep it inside the boundary line, does so successfully, kicks into the pocket, finds a free man. They play on straight away. Callaway, in fact, it's Cameron Jordan, kicks towards goal, but it was touched on the line and one behind for Greensborough, gets them level with Eltham, 1-1 apiece.
Not his best effort there, certainly the right call to play on, but he just kept it low, and it was obviously never going to get through with numbers on the goal line there. So not his best effort, but he's looking lively early. It's 7 apiece as the ball now to exit defensive 50 through Caulfield for Eltham.
It was such dangerous transition, wasn't it? Going from all the way through the back half after Chris Aratus gave away that free kick deep in the 450 for Eltham. The transition all the way up the ground there from Greensborough. In particular, Nick Riddle keeping the ball in was absolutely sensational here on the near wing in front of the scoreboard. The umpire about to restart things here as the ball, as Sam said, was out of bounds. And no, in fact, it's going to be Matty Hyde. I think it was out on the full.
I think it surprised a few. Everyone had sent it up for a throw-in. But
So, long high ball here from Hyde up in the Fowler direction. Great mark there by Billy Glasgow. He read it better than anyone else, and he takes the mark at centre-half back. And now he switches out wide to the left wing. Tommy Rogers takes the mark, experienced player. Finished equal third in the Rosbrook Trophy last year, and he goes long on the left foot in the direction of Burns. A couple of Greensborough players are able to meet the ball. Long kick by Grubb in the direction of Josh Riddle and Stanton. They both crash the pack. Ball comes to ground. Now at ground level, McQuilkin looking for the hand pass. He's eventually going to get it here. Hemmed up on the boundary. Gets a hand ball back to Josh Riddle, involved again. And now once more McQuilkin. Swinging ball towards the goal square. He's just off to the left. And it will be one behind the skipper.
He'd probably be disappointed with that. He got onto that preferred left boot there, but he just wasn't able to bend it back far enough. I think he probably had a fraction more time than he thought. But it's Greensborough 1-2-8. Eltham 117, the Borough in front for the first time today. We've played 7.5 minutes.
Lockie Richardson exits from defence, finds a man out on right half back, but they've given away a free kick here, Eltham.
It's front on contact there from Mullins. I think he was going for the mark and intercepting their balance. Eyes not on the footy, made contact with the player, so rightfully so, Mullins gets the free kick.
Good option.
And kicks into the pocket and finds Matty Fowler, who was all by himself. He's about 45 metres around from Greensborough's goal, probably a tight angle for him to kick from. Got his eyes up, looking inside the forward 50 for a better target.
Relaxed marking from Brovidani.
He's got a couple of leads coming towards him.
Was an ear player who really stood up last year. Actually, it's going to be reversed here, it looks like. So a bit going on in the goal square, and Fowler now has to give the ball. Well, he should have given it across to his direct opponent there in Lewis Glasgow, but instead he's thrown it to the ground and given a 50-metre penalty. So instead of having a shot, the ball now advances to the wing for Eltham.
So Brovidani, the young man, 18 years old, on right centre wing, kicks long inside forward 50. They come from the back. Greensborough have numbers there. Atkins doing some defensive work. Chris Aratus from the boundary line has a stab at goal, but getting back on the last line was McClendon. Just stuck a paw on it and rushed it over for one more behind.
That was going goal bound from deep on the boundary in the right forward pocket. Would have been an incredible goal had it been put through. But McClendon, as you said there, on the last line defence. Now Hyde bringing it out with a long ball in the McQuilkin direction. He's a little bit undersized against DiPaolo. DiPaolo with the punch brought it to ground.
Danger.
And a dangerous handball into the corridor is in the arms of Rogers. Rogers is able to get it to his teammate there in Evans, the former Bundoora man. His little ball inside is in the arms of Brovidani, the man who got the free kick before. His kick a little bit wide and a little bit sloppy, and Greensborough able to recover on the wing. They must take their opportunities when they get half chances here, Eltham. because when Greensborough get their half chances, they will put them through. They are a very disciplined side when going forward most of the time. Another free kick has been pulled out here, another 50 metres.
Yeah.
And it will be Lockie Richardson who has the ball on the right wing.
Just some ill discipline early on from Greensborough. Didn't see too much of this last year, it has to be said, but two early free kicks off the ball and now two 50-metre penalties as Eltham go forward again. And another whistle off the ball, and it's going to be another Eltham free kick from directly in front of goal. Didn't spot that one there, but it looks like the ball's in the hands of James Chrysaratis, and he'll go back to kick what would be his first major of the season. He has booted 82 goals over the past two seasons, and this is for him really his bread and butter.
And Benny Turner wouldn't be happy with that at all, giving Chrysaratis easy opportunities with a hand over the shoulder free kicks for an easy set shot to just get him going in the season of 2015. And he puts it through for his first goal for the year and Eltham's second of the day.
And I guess the one with him as well, you don't want him to get early goals and get his confidence up. We saw him kick 8 in a game against Northcote Park last year, and I'm not saying he's a confidence player, but if he gets a couple early, he's really hard to stop. So Eltham out to an early jump here, 2-2-14, Greensborough 1-2-8. We have played 10 and a half minutes in the first term, and it has to be said for mine, Eltham looking the better of the two sides so far.
The tackling pressure's been outstanding, and as we mentioned before, the discipline from some of the Greensborough boys hasn't been what it normally is.
So Hooper now doing the ruck work from the centre bounce for Greensborough, his first tap of the year. Try to get it down to Fowler, but there's just plenty of scrap going on inside the centre square. Finally finds its way out to Bailey Taglieri, new player this year for Eltham. The ball's gone high out towards half forward for the Panthers, but coming in to mark from the side was Matty Hyde. He's been with the club since 2013, Matty Hyde. Kicks long up the line, looking for Hooper underneath it. Just gone a bit beyond him. Richardson out the back trying to chase it down. He is grub with his hands to the footy. Whistle's gone and the umpire says we'll have a ball up.
Been really impressed with Eltham's intent, laying some really big tackles there. On that occasion, Grubb, you probably would have fancied him to get through, but the tackles are sticking for the Panthers.
Grubb again across the boundary line, kicks towards the goal square. It's going to bounce up here for Stanton. Again, Richardson getting back, the experienced head of Lockie Richardson. Handball's over the top, a bit risky, but finds James Reid. Now they're going up through the centre of the ground. Still inside defensive 50. Now they go out wide. There's a one-on-one contest on the outer side of the ground. Looks like it's Braden Taglieri going up against Dan McClendon. Tries to shug Taglieri off. Did really well. Gets a handball off now to Callaway. Callaway rounds his man. Handball's out wide to Emery. Emery, the little back pocketer, playing up on centre wing. Kicks the ball out of bounds on the full inside of the ground centre wing.
Well, Fowler was in space there. If that kick had hit its target, he was probably off to the races. But enough pressure there from Eltham. And turning it over now, it's in safe hands with Lockie Richardson.
And Richardson does kick it further afield, but it's a bit of a grubber along the ground, and now a free kick for a push in the back will go to Liam Emery.
It's first commentator's curse of the year, I think, guys. You talk up his good kicking and he kicks an absolute shocker, but no free kick given. Hooper wins the ruck contest. Ball now in dispute, ends up out of bounds. We've gone 12 and a half minutes. Eltham 2-2-14, Greensborough 1-2-8.
Thought that was a push in the back, but no, the umpire did call the ball is mine. Now he does again. He throws it up to the two ruckmen. One down by DiPaolo, only as far as a couple of Greensborough players. Long ball from Brent Ryan in towards the forward 50. Ooh. Flying is Josh Grubb. Couldn't bring the mark down, but a great contest in the air. Brought the ball to ground. And the ball is now ushered out of bounds here by Daniel Caulfield for Eltham in the back pocket.
We've got a lot of those players at mid-size who can take a good mark overhead, don't they, Greensborough? They play tall than they probably actually are.
Rocks to go at it once more. It is Hooper on this occasion, and a great tap. He just belts it out into space in front of the two key forwards. Stanton overran it, and now Eltham have got a little bit of time to clear here. Chase Caulfield, he rushes the behind, and he will bring it in now. So another behind goes to the Greensborough side. Oh, kick off the mark was smothered brilliantly. It was Keane who had a little horrible turnover there, and now handball chain finds McQuilkin, and he puts through his first goal of the year.
The crowd, they're a bit quiet, aren't they, early on? No way. Early a few claps for that one there. Probably expecting things to, well, they would have hoped, a bit more simple for Greensborough, but certainly a different-looking Eltham side they're taking on this year. And both the Borough goals coming on their non-preferred foot there. Stanton on his left with the first, and then McQuilkin on his right there. But Greensborough not playing well, but they're still in front on the scoreboard. They're 2 goals, 3-15. Eltham's 2-2-14. We have played 14 minutes in the opening quarter of the season opener for 2015.
Williamson's gone into the ruck and he wins his first hit out straight down to the path of Taglieri. He ambled straight to Stead and he goes around the corner with a high up and under the direction of Grubb, who crashed two Eltham defenders. Now a handball out from Fowler, found Riddle. He gave it over the top back to Grubb. Grubb's got a man outside who swings a kick around the corner towards the goal square offhand. Maybe could have let it go there, Stanton. I couldn't quite see who had that flying shot on goal.
It was Stead who had the shot around the body. and the score reads 2 goals, 4-16, Greensborough, Eltham 2-2-14.
So coming out from fullback here for Eltham, James Reid with a long ball. It was a lovely ball as well, found Harrison Burns, who took it lace out over his head. And his handball to a man in space is Brovidani, and he takes on his direct opponent at halfback and goes long up in the Crusaders' direction. He's going to fly. May have put hands in the back there. Yes, he did. It'll be a Nick Riddle free kick at centre halfback.
So Nick Riddle, who had his last full season with Greensborough back in 2011, played for Collingwood VFL the last couple of years, co-capping them. Handball's out wide now to Matty Hyde, who kicks further wide to the wing. Near side of the ground, Williamson coming off the bench, took a nice big mark. Now gets a handball off to a teammate, and they're going back inside forward 50 here as Sam tries to kill a wasp in the commentary box. Kick long towards the goal. No one really there on the goal line there for Eltham, so the ball's just trickled out over the behind line, and one more behind for the Panthers.
Third time lucky in that attempt for that wasp. So we're back in safe hands here. Scores level here. It's 1 point the difference in play. 15 plays 16. McClendon goes forward looking for Clark on the volley. Great tackle there. That was from Robert Darney. Grub supporting there for Greensborough. Hamble, Clark, and was that McClendon? Actually, in fact, it might have been the newcomer there in Doherty. Was it that ran almost into each other? And a free kick's paid after all of that. And it's an Eltham football on left or right half back. It's going to be Robert Darney, who's been promising early. He's turned it over a few times, but he's certainly going hard at the ball, and he goes long down the line now.
Robert Darney kicks long towards the wing. A nice big mark taken overhead. Looks like that was Billy Glasgow.
He's taken a couple already.
He's a big boy, isn't he?
He's very good as well, Billy Glasgow. Kicks inside the forward 50, looking for Crusaratus on the lead. A nice big leap and takes it on the chest.
He can play this bloke.
That's the future of Eltham right there, isn't it? Brovidani goes to Glasgow, in turn finds Crusaratus on the lead, and strong marking all the way around that boundary line now. A chance for Eltham to kick their third.
Crusaratus will line up with plenty of the goal face to aim at. Wearing his very flashy blue and orange boots today, James Crusaratus. Kicked 53 goals last year for the Panthers to be their leading goal scorer. He's got one today. Starts this one right. It's going long, it's going high, and it's going straight through the middle. James Crusaratus has two.
He's a star, James Crusaratus. Great start of the year for him.
Well, he's kicked two, Eltham's kicked three, and they are back in the lead here as we get closer and closer to time on in the opening term. It is Eltham, 3 goals, 3-21. Greensborough, 2 goals, 4-16. And it all started with a good chase there from Brovidani. Got the holding the ball free kick, and I guess once they had that turnover, they really made Greensborough pay the burrow, not able to get their hands on the ball after losing it at left half forward.
Really taking on the game here, the Panthers, in round one of the 2015 Northern Football League season. Williamson wins it down only as far as McCrookin. Left foot tumbler high and long into space at half forward in front of Boyden. He can't meet it properly, couldn't take it cleanly. So Chase Caulfield sidesteps a couple. His kick out to halfback wasn't marked by Valance. It allows Doherty in his handball to Stanton. He'll be under pressure straight away, but he didn't even pick it up. Louis Glasgow was the first to grab the footy, and he gave it over to Brovidani. He's still under pressure. Tackle laid there by the Greensborough player. Eventually the handball comes out to Williamson, but a shocking kick by him. Direct turnover into the corridor to his opposite number in Hooper. Hooper's long ball out in the direction of McCook. Can he keep hitting? He does, the skipper. And then a little one into the pocket is not his cleanest piece of work, and it will be out of bounds for a boundary throw.
Not sure what Williamson was thinking there. I don't think it's too often that a ruckman actually gets a handball receive, and he was caught in two minds, wasn't he? Went the little pitching wedge over the top, but it went straight to Hooper. Fortunately, not made to pay.
So a throw in here in the forward pocket. Greensborough forward 50, 18 minutes played. Tap down there from Hooper. Big bump coming through from Josh Riddle. Still inside the forward pocket here, no clean possession. Eltham committing bodies to this challenge. Braden Taglieri is in there as well. He has hands to the footy, but ultimately nothing will come from that.
Stanton a little bit worse for wear after that hit.
Yeah, it was a big hit in that scrum.
Well, it was Billy Glasgow. He got straight back to his feet, but that's what Josh Riddle brings to Greensborough, that hard edge on the footballer. Stanton intercepts here, can't quite pick it up. Ball towards the boundary. Just be kept in, but it won't go anywhere. The umpire calls for the ball. Right in the forward pocket. 19 minutes played. It's Greensborough 16, trailing Eltham 21.
Throw up in the pocket, hard up against the boundary line. Tap down there from Williamson, out to Taglieri. A mashing of handballs, intercepted by Hooper. Tries to bash his way through one. Gets a handball off to Stead, who kicks from directly in front.
Sensational Greensborough footy there.
Only problem was with the minor side of the goalpost. So just 1 point. it would have been a great goal. Hooper and Stead, both evading would-be tacklers, but in the end, Stead's kick just missed to the near side. It's Greensborough 2-5-17, Eltham 3-3-21.
As a big man going through traffic there, I don't know if I've seen many better efforts than that one from Mickey Hooper, with the clean hands being able to swivel his way around smaller, more agile players. As Eltham move out from half-back, and now they've moved it to the wing through Tommy Rogers. His handball to Woods. He has now got the ball on the wing. He releases Glasgow, and he was under pressure straight away, so he just tumbles one into the forward 50. Tackled straight away was Wachowski, and now at ground level, able to clear here for Greensborough. Long ball out in the direction of a teammate, but couldn't quite find him. And the mark is taken there by Valance at half forward. The man that was they were searching for was Doherty. The kick inside forward 50 from Valance, now brought to ground level. Now moving away here from half back, Josh Griffiths. He's got the run of the foot. He's able to pick it up cleanly in the right back pocket. Now with a right foot kick. Oh, it was perfect. It found Grubb.
Great body work by Grubb there.
He got in front of Laurie, and he's able to take a good mark. He's been a very good player for a long time for the Borough here, Grubb. But that kick on that occasion, probably not his best one. He's normally a slick mover of the ball, but not that time. Now Eltham going forward again. Here's Laurie. His kick high, up and under, almost lands in the arm of Merkel. He has to go again at ground level. Here's Woods once more, gave it off to Glasgow. He's got a chance to shoot for goal. He's pulled it to the left. First score of the year for Billy Glasgow, one behind.
Have a breather there, Tom. Good call. 21 minutes approaching. It's Greensborough 2-5-17, Eltham 3-4-22. It's been a bruising contest early. Each player having to work for each kick they get in. You see Doug Morris floating the crowd there, of course, now moving across the Lowell Plenty from the Northcote Park Footy Club.
Long kick out from fullback from Hyde. Harrison Burns meets it on the outer side here. A little handball from Williamson. Eltham in possession on the wing. Here's Valance, kicks towards the forward 50. Marking is Lewis Glasgow across right half forward. Wants to go quickly, just weighing up which option to make, which option to go to. Kicks just to the hot spot, and Nick Riddle was there underneath it trying to mark it. Ball again in dispute. 30 metres out from Eltham's goal, and the umpire will call for a ball up.
Crucial situation here for the Panthers. I don't know how often they're going to get these sort of situations throughout the day where they can use their midfield to good effect. Almost could have done it then if they had been able to get it cleanly. Still with the ball here, Woods. His handball was a little bit awry, and it lands in the arms of Stead. He's able to burst away from a Tommy Rogers tackle and then goes laterally with his run and his kick up in the direction of Riddle. Oh, he completely coat-hanged his direct opponent there, Keen Riddle, but the umpire obviously didn't see that one. There's McQuilkin going in hard, gave it to Atkins. Bodies crashing in everywhere. Louis Glasgow, his handball out. Riddle once again. Josh Riddle, gee, he's had a great first quarter, hasn't he? He gives it off to Callaway, and his left foot ball finds Cameron Jordan. Now they can calm down a little bit here, Greensborough. A little bit less frenetic than it was a moment ago. Jordan's kick to Stanton was fantastic, but he's stuffed that mark up. It was right in his pouch, but he let go of it at the last second. Free kick has gone. I think the advantage was about to be taken by the Greensborough boys, but the umpire says no. Bring it back to Stanton, who is 65 metres out from the Greensborough goal.
They were away if he had have taken that mark. They had a 2-on-1 in the goal square, but Stanton really dropped it if he should have taken it.
Numbers are back now, but he is going to launch it long to the 1-on-1, and Boyden's got the sit. Oh, he couldn't quite take the mark. He crashed the pack. There were three or four defenders in front of him, and he's given a free kick away to one of them. That one is Matt Williams.
I think if you're Ben Turner, you don't mind that. I know he's given a free kick away, but he's making defenders, really know that he's charging out of the goal square there, and it might just make them hesitate the next time they have to go back.
Yeah, he rushed hard, Reece Boyd, and this is Taglieri for Eltham. Goes straight to the middle and finds a teammate there, and Kieran Keane, who put his teammate under a bit of trouble with the hospital handball. Greensborough again trying to pounce on that one. Loose foot inside their forward line. Umpire says we'll have a ball up. Just about 30 metres out from Greensborough's goal, directly in front. Eltham just a bit wavering under the pressure inside defensive 50.
Free kick pay here. It's going to go to Jordan for a hold from that ball up. So Jordan is within range here. Disappointing there for Eltham. I'm sure they'd love to take a lead of any size into the first break when playing the reigning premier away from home in the opening round of the year. But if Jordan can kick truly here from 40 metres out, no real angle to speak of, it will be the Borough taking the one-point advantage here. So we approach the 24-minute mark of the first quarter, and Jordan comes in now, shot on goal, looks pretty good, it holds its line, and he has put one through there. Cameron Jordan kicks his first goal for the afternoon, and it is Greensborough back in front by one solitary behind there. 3 goals, 5-23, Eltham 3 goals for 22. We've played 24 minutes in the first term.
They've been fantastic, Eltham, the way that they've attacked the footy and the way that they've attacked the man from the opposition and laid tackles and their run and ball delivery and linking up through the middle has been fantastic. But a couple of little silly errors, a couple of undisciplined acts and a couple of skill errors in the back half have cost them dearly with a couple of goals to Greensborough as a long torpedo punt ball comes out of the middle of the goal square. I think there's going to be a holding free kick. It will be against Stanton. He thought he should have had the free kick. Now, playing on out of full-back, Chase Caulfield. His kick is a dangerous one. Just bobbed it up to his teammate, Bailey Taglieri. He had to work really hard to bring the ball to ground. Now, possibly a free kick there for Greensborough for too high. No, not paid. Lockie McCulkin's able to get a handball off to a teammate, and the kick is good. Greensborough have got another goal.
Josh Grubb there, and it got into dangerous hands. Gene McCulkin's been industrious in this first quarter. He's been involved in everything. There's a bit of a to-do afterwards here. Caulfield and Griffiths is it's broken up now by the umpire, but he's been involved in everything. He's kicked the goal himself, and he might have had a second earlier on where he just didn't get a handball to sit up for himself, but the Borough now lead by 7 points, and you probably think they haven't played their best football, boys.
25 minutes gone in this first quarter. Chase Caulfield is playing fullback on Reece Boyd and has looked very nervous. He's made a couple of mistakes in this first term and was, I guess, the main catalyst for giving that goal away to Eltham, to Greensborough. This is Eltham, though, on the ball with captain Braden Taglieri going inside the forward 50. Nick Riddle getting back on the last line, taking a very nice mark. He's got a couple of runners on the near side of the ground. Matty Fowler's one of them. Finds himself in open space, unmarked, and takes the ball across left half back.
Doherty on a long lead.
Wants to go up the line first. Decides to. Just didn't really come off well, that kick, but it goes up towards the wing. Lockie Richardson coming through. Gets a handball away. Coming through now, Eltham with a little handball on. Just trying to string some handballs together. He's tagged the area again. Rounds one and then has an area at his kick, but I think he might have been pushed off the ball. No, he wasn't. Umpire said play on. McQuiggan had a kick, but there is the quarter-time siren.
Stanton had a paddock. And at the siren had they gone?
At the end of that term, it is Greensborough 4-5-29, leading Eltham 3-4-22. At the end of the first quarter of the first game of the year, they lead by 7.
So, and not panic, he thought a few times they turned over at crucial situations, but he felt they were the better side in that first quarter.
Back in the middle, Hooper won it down to McQuilkin. Mullins going in hard. He's wrapped up straight away after he tried to pick it up a second time. Okay, good tackle away there. And the ball to be thrown up once again right in the middle of War Memorial Park. It was a neutral hit out down at ground level. Here is Keane. He gave it over to Burns. His nice work in tight. Taglieri long kick to Chris Aratus. Great spoil from the back. It was brilliant work there by Brent Ryan. And now through Matty Hyde, Greensborough can get away. Here is Josh Griffiths. He grabs the ball in half back and goes with a long high one in the direction of Josh Riddle. Ball at ground level now. Came out of the back of his hand, trying to spin through a tackle, was Grubb. He got a handball out. Now Griffiths gets involved again after he got it from Clark. His kick to half forward. Might be a free kick here to Boyden.
It was. Just pushed into that contest and probably had the sit, didn't he? And the defender behind having to infringe it. But just going back to the quarter-time huddle from Mario Bandera, obviously he was disappointed with their entries going inside 50. He thought they were untidy, but as we mentioned a couple of times, just with those handballs in the back, like a few times in dangerous situations, just sold teammates into trouble and really resulted in turnover goals.
So Boyden, here he comes from the paint of the 50, or possibly a little bit further. He swung it back beautifully with the breeze. That is a lovely kick from Reece Boyden. He knows this ground well. He's got his first of the year.
So the Borough kick 3 goals in succession either side of quarter time, and now they have the biggest lead of the contest to date. It is Greensborough, 5 goals, 5-35. Eltham, 3-4-22. And a whistle's been blown off the ball here, and it's going to be a yellow card, and I'm not too sure who's picked that one up. It's Stanton, it looks like, is running off the ground, so it may well be a free kick in the middle of the ground. To Eltham it is, but they did go to play on quickly, but having to wait for Stanton to make his way off the ground. So it's going to be what looks to be an Eltham ball in the middle. A fair bit going on early in the second quarter.
So only 2 minutes into the second quarter, and with Eltham, Greensborough, pardon me, already a player down with Stanton going off with the yellow. It'll be a free kick from the middle for the Panthers. They've got a couple of options inside the forward line. Chris Aratus obviously one. Burns on the near side. They decide to go to the outer side of the field looking for Valance. He had the ball but just slipped through his fingers at the last second. A little handball on. Valance wants to get it back across half forward. Under pressure by Josh Riddle coming through Emery. Lays a big bump. Clark is around there as well. Plenty of hands to the footy. Many players diving in, forcing a ball up on right half forward for the Panthers.
Umpire to throw it up. will be Hooper going up against Williamson again. Williamson hit it only as far as McCulkin, who gave it off to Clark. His swing kick around the corner under pressure, and Wayward out of bounds on the full.
I think Eltham's really going to just keep working on that work rate, I guess, and keeping it high. They were really good in the first 15 minutes of that first quarter, putting Greensborough under a mountain of pressure.
Lateral ball and then a long one in the direction of Williamson, and off his hands it will go out of bounds. There's a big pack there at half forward for Eltham. Greensborough defenders able to shut it down for a stoppage.
So across right half forward to be thrown in just about 50 metres out from the Eltham goal. Coming through there, looks like it might be James Reid who's caught up in a tackle, but the ball wasn't really moving, so the umpire calls for it. We'll have a secondary ball up. Looks like Williamson doing the ruck work against Hooper. Hooper gets a tap down. Again, Reid hands to the footy. Again, Mullins has him wrapped up, and again we'll have another ball up.
That tackling pressure once again has not relented, either of these sides, since the start of the contest. Going up is Hooper. He won it down to McQuilkin. And under a lot of players there is McQuilkin. Got wrapped up by a couple of Eltham boys. It will be yet another stoppage. Same position at half forward for the Eltham Panthers.
Paolo doing the ruck work here against Mickey Hooper. For Eltham, Hooper gets a tap down, finds a man who just weaves his way through traffic. This is Tristan Stead. A good couple of years for Greensboro the last 2 years, but that wasn't good.
Final series last year.
That wasn't a good kick, though. It's fallen straight into the arms of Lockie Richardson on centre wing. Near side of the ground, far side of the ground, pardon me, left foot kick. That's gone out of bounds on the full as well. So Greensboro will have a free kick on the outer side.
Nick Riddle.
Riddle takes it and goes short inside the defensive 50. The following kick as well follows suit. This is Matty Hyde across full back. Comes out to the back pocket, sees a man hard up against the boundary line. That was a tight little situation there for Dan McClendon, but made it work, took the mark, and now kicks inside. Greensboro still inside defensive 50 here, just chipping around, taking their time. Matty Hyde across the right back pocket.
I think they're just happy to control the ball. We saw both sides in the first quarter turn it over a few times. Eltham have talked about a number of times, probably cost them 3 goals, but Greensboro here just showing their experience, holding the ball. Now it's steady at half back. It's just short 20-metre passes, just controlling the tempo.
Emery in space over the top, and Stead looks for him and does find him now. Balance was a little bit too late for that one. Now he's got Callaway further afield, and also a little bit of help from Riddle. If Riddle can pick up, it was a poor kick from Emery, but Riddle still has a bit of time and space to get it to that man, Callaway. He doesn't go for it. He goes for another teammate, and he couldn't quite pick it up on that occasion. Now Eltham out of defence. Emery charging hard for Greensboro. He got bashed off the footy, but Riddle was there to help him, and now handball chain finds Chris Clark. Callaway on the outside, he could have given him a handball too. He didn't decide to do that. He decided to go long to the hot spot. Now McQuilkin, he could rove and snap and goal, but he can't because it will be an Eltham free kick.
Just a bit reckless from Mullins coming over the top there of I think Billy Glasgow, centre half back. So here is the free kick for the Panthers. Just a short one inside the centre square. Richardson just
the heart rate rose there.
Lucky Richardson, plenty of experience to take that mark. Been playing with Eltham since 1998, can you believe? Kicks long out towards left half back. The mark not taken out there by his teammate. A nice follow-up effort, and they get the ball back here through a teammate through the middle. Now they're running. This is Braden Taglieri. Handballs off to a teammate in Glasgow. Taglieri goes at it again, brought to ground. Plenty of numbers in there for Greensborough. And they have. It's holding the ball. In fact, that was James Reid in the middle of the ground, not Taglieri. It's number 34, not 24. So here is Tristan Stead in the circles. Finds a man out wide. That's plenty of space out there found by Matty Fowler. In fact, it's Conti, who is one of the emergencies today. Late in inclusion into the side. And this is Chris Clark now, hard up against the boundary line. Across right half forward, just on the junction of where the 50 meets the boundary line.
Hooper calling for it long.
It's going to take quite an effort. Looks like he's lining up for the banana. Is he? Let's have a look. Chris Clark from deep on the pocket. Kicks long towards goal. Oh, big mark over the top.
Reece Boyden.
Whew. Marks on the line. And I reckon Chris Clark had that bit of play in mind. Reece Boyden takes a mark 5 metres out.
I think at times he often went under the shadow of Tim Bonchetti. But you look at his stats, Boyden, and so impressed. He's 51 senior games, 109 goals. And he's obviously had to overcome injury as he just knocks that one over the umpire's head. He's got two for this quarter. The only two majors of this term, and Greensboro extends its advantage to 19 points, 6 goals, 5.41. Eltham, 3 goals, 4.22. But to go it better than 2 goals a game in that early part of his career, and to, I guess, now be that sole forward, you expect a big year for Boyden. And he played a big role in that premiership. You just think individually, he's probably going to start to get the reward he probably so much deserves after a good start to his career.
was fantastic in that premiership campaign last year. Reece Boyden probably unlucky to miss last week in the representative game. Long ball up to half forward here for Greensborough. Chance for another goal if they can take clean possession. No, nice work there at the back. Cox is able to take possession here, but he's turned it over straight to Stead. His snap around the corner. Is that through? No, it's off to the right for one behind. Stead's second behind of the day. Yet again, another handball under pressure in the back 50 when there was opposition closing in.
So it is 20 points the difference. Greensborough leading here with 8 minutes played in the second term. The reigning premier's taken on the team that finished ninth last year. And Eltham play on from the kick out and then go long towards the outer side. And here Greensborough players underneath this one. Josh Laurie had to work, but obviously outnumbered. And they give away possession to the bar. Richardson comes through, lays a big tackle.
Free kick.
Rewarded.
And he gets the free kick from it. Nick Riddle, Josh Riddle just a bit slow to get the handball away. So Richardson, the 35-year-old, very much the oldest statesman of this side. Playing in his trademark long sleeves, rolled up to the elbow. Kicks one long and high up towards half forward. Hyde flies for it. Coming through Rogers, gets a handball off to Taglieri. Does well to avoid trouble. This is Woods. Handball's off now to another teammate. Looks like Burns is about to run onto it here. In fact, it might be Rogers. He gets around one. Dances past another. A left foot kick, but he was put under pressure. And that one's gone out of bounds on the full.
He was just untidy getting it to him. If it had have sat for him, he would have surely run in on that left boot. We know he's one of the quicker players in the competition. But just that ball to him wasn't tidy. And in the end, it ends up out of bounds on the full. Greensborough now to bring the ball back into play.
Long ball out to the right half back flank. He's going to be marked by the skipper, Josh Merkel. He takes it about 50 metres out. He'll be kicking from 55, probably too far out to score, so he'll put it up to the hot spot. Flying will be Burns. Slipped through his hands. Out the back, Matty Hyde, calm under pressure. He gave it over to Emery, who's able to release Jordan, who's moved to the back half. His long kick was sensational, and it was able to find the skipper, McCookin, who released the midfielder, Stead. Long ball to half forward, crashing mark. He's just hammered a couple of blokes on his way through there, Josh Riddle. He's taken a good grab at 50.
How good has Cameron George's kicking been today?
Outstanding.
Over 30 metres. He can hit someone on the chest like nothing else.
I think now their experienced defenders are really starting to have a real say in this game. On that situation there, McClendon and Riddle went up. Hyde stayed down. He mopped up that loose ball. The only man who stayed down. And then Fowler ran through and Jordan as well. But those wiser heads in that back 50 are really starting to shine through as Josh Riddle kicks his first goal on return to the Borough, and they are off to a racing start in this second term. They've kicked the only 3 goals of the quarter, and it is the Borough 7 goals 6:48, Eltham 3:4:22. We have gone in this term some 10.5 minutes, and they kick 5 in a row now, boys, and I guess some real concerns now for the Eltham Footy Club.
Real concerns, and those concerns come from Eltham. You know, they have played well. They linked up really well through the ground. We saw a fantastic handball chain before that ended with Tommy Rogers, and he just couldn't get the last part right. And that's happened a few times already today, whereas Greensborough, when they get those half chances, they seem to always put them through. Coming out of the middle, it was Doherty wrapped up in a tackle, so there will be a secondary stoppage in the middle of the ground after that goal. And rucks to go at it once more. Atkins back in the ruck, won it down. At ground level, there was Stead going in hard. And now another Greensborough player wrapped up by Kieran Keane. That was Emery at the bottom of the pack. And the Rucks will go at it once more. It is Atkins once again. He's going up against DiPaolo. Nil all draw there in the hit-out. Ball at ground level. Going in hard. Who's wrapped up the man Keane. McCookin going in hard also. He was wrapped up by Cox. Plenty of great tackling pressure from both sides here early on in this, throughout this whole first half.
Ball tap down there from the Hooper. It's going to go the way of Greensborough. A little handball out wide, finds Stead. Just stops on the spot, gets on his right boot and kicks long inside the forward 50. Making a big lead, Boyden. Look for the chest mark. Probably should have gone with hands out in front. Coming through Rogers. Handball's off now to Woods, who dances around one and just puts a little chip kick over the top and finds a man in Witkowski.
He's good there, Woods, wasn't he? Broke through a couple and it was a good decision by Foot.
Witkowski goes long up the line with a straight kick, but it's... looks like it's going to fall into the path of McClendon. Had to beat off his man in Harry Burns and did so very well. Gets a handball up the line now. A bit of pressure there from Woods. Takes his man in a tackle. They still have possession here, Greensborough. This is Jordan. Just grabbed a kick on the half volley up to McQuilkin. And now the kick around the body.
Pressure.
Smothered off the boot of Desmond. Gets it back the second time though. Did well. Kicks inside the forward 50, but that one's been cut off. It's been marked across half back by Daniel Caulfield. across the defensive edge of the centre square, goes inside and finds Richardson, who's been probably the main possession getter today for Eltham. Wobbles a kick inside the forward 50. Hyde had to trap that one on the ground. Amble out now to Ryan, who finds a man on the outer side in Callaway. Gets on the left and kicks up the line. And again, Lockie Richardson sits under it and takes another calming chest mark.
Not the best passage of play there for either side. Richardson turning one over, then Callaway. That's another shocking kick inside. Lands to Merkel. Here's a chance.
Oh,
running into the goal. Laurie got around one. And in the end, his finishing just evading him there. One minor score. Eltham's first score for the quarter. We've gone 13 minutes. A minor one. 3 goals, 5:23. Eltham. Greensborough 7-6-48. It's an understatement, but the Panthers certainly need the next goal.
It was a fantastic sidestep from Laurie, but once again, the execution not there for the Panthers. Matty Hyde at fullback. Long tumbling ball in between two teammates. Went through the hands of one of them. Now Griffiths having to go hard to reclaim possession here for the Borough. Woods also in there, and now McCrookin being able to pick up the footy. He releases a teammate in Fowler, who had Riddle. Riddle's handball over the top. Now Fowler at ground level once more. He's wrapped up there by Woods again, but still the ball comes free here through Griffiths. He's tackled straight away, but he's able to get a handball to Mullins. Mullins over to Riddle of the Josh variety. His kick laterally into the middle of the ground, almost marked there, and it was a great second effort to pick it up there from Doherty, and he released Jordan with a long kick to Boyden. Almost clunked it. Couldn't quite. Ball at ground level. Going in hard to Caulfield. He'll be wrapped here, up here by Boyden in a minute. Boyden did lay a big tackle on him. But the umpire...
he's paid the free kick. But yeah, it's a great second effort by Boyden. He charged out on that lead. Didn't take the mark, but he was just as good at ground level. Centering ball now. Lots of numbers. And getting back and taking the mark was Richardson. But it's a free kick to Greensborough. I think a Shepherd off the ball it might well be. And it's going to be a ball to Josh Riddle from just outside the goals. Because certainly not against Richardson there. He ran back with the flight, took it on the chest. But a Shepherd off the ball. And Josh Riddle is going to kick his second goal in 5 minutes. And Greensborough's advantage is going to stretch beyond the 5-goal margin.
He's been close to best on ground in this first half, Riddle. And he bangs through second. And the Borough are running away here late in the first half.
Big crowd in, but they certainly aren't as vocal as we used to here at Greensborough. I think it's becoming the expectation now to win games of football and win them well. And at the moment, they're getting their premiership defence off to a great start. The Borough, 8 goals, 6:54. Eltham, 3-5-23. We've gone 15 minutes in the second term. Greensborough with the only 4 goals for this quarter.
It's just another day of footy for the Greensborough fans. They lead by 31 points. 15 minutes into the second term. Josh Riddle joins Reece Boyden as multiple goal scorer today for Greensborough. It is 54 playing at 23. Greensborough with a healthy advantage as we enter the last couple of stages, probably the last 10 minutes of the second term before halftime. Umpire balls it up for the restart. Atkins in the ruck, gets a tap to it, wanted to follow it up, but Glasgow got hands to the footy first and goes long inside forward 50. Hyde out the back, uses his strength well. And just recovers the possession in defence for Greensborough. Gets around on the right, hooks a kick up towards centre wing. Coming in from the side again, Billy Glasgow. Current best and fairest for the Panthers. On centre wing, out of side. Just trying to make a decision of where to go to. Decides after weighing up a kick with a handball. Goes long inside the forward 50. That's a high kick and just has it gone out of bounds on the full. No, it's just been kept in.
Hard again.
Keane couldn't track it down and it goes out for a boundary throw-in at right half forward, 40 metres around from the Eltham goal. Ball to be thrown in across half forward. In the ruck is Williamson. The ball eludes both ruckmen. Secondary tap out the back there from Hooper. Finds Valance. Coming through now is the Eltham player in Evans. Trying to win the ball back, and now there's a long high kick going towards the hot spot underneath it. Has the mark been taken by the Eltham player? I think it has.
James Chrysaratis again.
Well, mark free kick, take your pick. Ryan did his best from behind there, dragged Chrysaratis to the ground, and he still marked it. He's still got the two arms extended, and he's at the moment the only forward looking really dangerous for Eltham. I know they're being starved of opportunities, but Chrysaratis, you feel for them to win this game of football, is going to have to kick a big bag today as he lines up for his third of what would be Eltham's fourth goal.
So 53 goals last year for James Chrysaratis. 2 goals today in the first 2 quarters. And this one to end a streak of 6 straight goals for Greensborough. Chrysaratis, kick on the way.
Got it.
And it's gone straight through.
Gee, he just poked at it, didn't he? But it was straight through the middle. And Chrysaratis has 3 goals. Eltham has its fourth, a much needed one. Ends a run of 6 straight goals for the Borough. And it is Eltham, 4 goals, 5:29. Greensborough, 8-6-54. We've gone 17 minutes here at War Memorial Park. It is Good Friday football, and it is the season opener for the 2015 NFL season.
Playing a lone hand up front, Chrysaratis. and has his third of the day. Ball back in the middle, going in hard. Is Woods able to get a handball out to teammate Glasgow, wrapped up straight away. And we'll get a free kick, Louis Glasgow, and switches it wide to the outer side of the ground. Finds a teammate, Brovadani, his chip over the top. Finds the man in Evans. His short ball is into the arms of Glasgow. This is good ball movement. Some nice chip passing around the ground to move the ball forward. Glasgow goes long into the direction of Taglieri, and a free kick has been paid for a hold. Will be another Eltham free kick, and I think it's going to be Chrysaradis again for his second in a minute and his fourth of the day.
Well, we said he needed to kick a bag for them to win the game, or at least stay in it. This to be his fourth, and we're just approaching time on in the second quarter. So obviously the real worry there is his great strength is contested marking, and now he gets a free kick, as they obviously know that he's got his hands working today, and they've just panicked in defence, a chance for his fourth.
Well, this is the way they're going to get goals, because at ground level Greensborough are so composed. But Chrysaradis, he's running amok here in the first half, and he may just have Eltham back into the contest with his fourth goal.
How good is he from the set shot, James Chrysaradis?
Doesn't miss those ones there, and all of a sudden, after Greensborough looked in great control, Eltham peg a couple of back. They bring it back to 19 points. It is Eltham 6 goals, 339. Greensborough 8-6-54. We are at War Memorial Park. If you are around on this Good Friday, do get down. Massive crowd already in attendance. Great footy being played. And the Panthers, they're back in the contest. Just 19 points in it.
19 minutes gone. 19 points the margin. Atkins doesn't really win the tap. Just had an air swing in it. Ball goes to ground. Players diving in on top. Taglieri handballs out now to Rogers, who takes a bounce. A left foot kick long inside the forward 50 for Eltham. Can they take a mark? Is it going to go through for a goal? No, it doesn't. Just out to the left. One more behind for Eltham. It's now 8-6-54. Greensborough to Eltham 5-6-36. A straight 3-goal margin.
They're breaking even in the midfield. They just need to work out a solid method of getting goals regularly. And Chrysaradis has seemed to be that avenue so far today. If they could find one or two more, this game could really even up. Now the ball at half forward here for Eltham. They've got another opportunity here through Evans. Chip up towards Burns and Merkel. Burns had a grab at it, but the ball came to ground level. Now working out of defence here is Griffiths with a long ball. Finds Grubb, who takes it while staring at the sun. That's a pretty impressive effort. His kick out wide finds Josh Riddle, who's taking yet another mark. He's everywhere across this half forward line at the moment, Josh Riddle.
He just got off the leash there, and once they got the ball, they just ran hard, didn't they? And Eltham caught on the transition there as Riddle now loads up from outside of range. He's just going to have the carry. It's just going to go through for a major goal as well. Didn't know if he'd have the carry there, but he played on quickly, probably made 5 metres, and it just hugged the inside goalpost. Fortunately, it didn't skim, and Riddle has his third goal. Of course, his brother was the NFL's best in last week's 5-point loss to the Baffa, and Josh is putting on a clinic here in the second quarter, his third for the turn. And Greensborough, well, they just pegged one back when Eltham was coming, and the margin back out to 24 points. It is Greensborough, 9 goals, 660. Eltham, 5 goals, 636.
And there was quick ball movement as well with the kick out of defence to the centre and then inside forward 50. And there's another long kick going inside forward 50 for the Borough. Stanton just held off the ball coming through. That looks like it was Richardson with the handball off to Cofford, I believe that was. Kicks now out to the outer wing. Rogers gathers, tries to ride the tackle, can't. Just got his handball away, did he? Or will there be a free kick? There will be a free kick. It's going to go the way of Greensborough.
Another goal here would really hurt for the Panthers. You've just been halted off that little charge that they made with the two Chrysaradis goals.
Quilkin goes into the pocket, makes it a bit tight for Mullins, who just takes the mark. Left half forward. We're into time on here in the second term. Greensborough lead by 4 straight kicks. Mullins just weighing up his options. Might even go back and have a set shot. No, he decides to go short into the pocket, and the mark is taken by Stanton. He's come on after being yellow carded earlier in this second term, and Stanton is lining up for a shot at goal to be his second if he converts.
So Stanton, he's obviously just back on the field. He got a yellow card earlier in this quarter after the first goal when Boyden converted. And he's back on. He's looking to have an immediate impact from deep in the pocket. That was always missing near side, minor score. And, well, we've got an incorrect scoreboard at the moment, but certainly the score is Greensborough 9-7-61, Eltham 5-6-36. Scoreboard reading, 1 extra goal to the Panthers there. Made a charge in this second term, Greensborough. Eltham weathered it for a good 5 minutes, but the Borough, in the past couple, have got back on top.
Field at fullback, releasing the ball out to Glasgow. Almost found him, but I don't think it touched any hand, so it might be out of bounds on the full. Umpire said no, it did just snick a fingertip on its way through, so it will be a throw-in on the right half-back flank here. Now umpire to throw it in, and he's got Atkins going up against DiPaolo in the ruck. Atkins was able to tap it over the top into the space of Grubb, who wasn't able to take it cleanly. We might get it back here after a little bit of a paddle from Callaway. He does get it now, Grubb. He swings it back out to Callaway. He's got time to turn his opponent inside out. Great tackle by Evans, but he's still able to take possession of the footy. Went after it again. Both those players went after it again. Now Glasgow going in hard, wrapped up by Atkins. Going in hard also is Caulfield. Handball out to Josh Riddle. Surely he couldn't kick a goal from there. Deep on the boundary. No, he sets it up for Boyden. Intelligent kick it was, because it's going to almost find Stead. No, it's going to get out to Brovidani deep in the back pocket. He was cool under pressure, and he found an outlet in the opposite back pocket.
So this is Caulfield. He's just slowing down the tempo now for Eltham. Wants to make sure he makes the right decision with his kick, because Greensboro's pressure has been very up-tempo in this second quarter. Finds Harrison Burns, who finds Valance on the outside. A right foot kick inside forward 50. There's two on one against Williamson. The one in front.
Crossovardis is on here if they can get it forward.
The ball is just scrapping around the forward line here. Billy Glasgow fighting hard for it for the Panthers. The umpire calls for it, and there'll be a ball up on the 50 for Eltham.
Well, his good plays meant that Nick Riddle's gone to him now. They've made the move, so it just keeps Riddle a bit more accountable as well.
Ball up on 50. DiPaolo did the ruck work. Woods handballs over the top looking for a teammate. A snap kick around the body was smothered off the boot. It's going to trickle towards the boundary line. Chris Aratus tried to get possession back. Hyde come under pressure. Got a handball out wide to Stanton. Hyde again. Hard up against the boundary line. Exits defensive 50 and finds a man right under pressure. And the mark is taken by Griffiths.
I think that's been one of the major keys to the game so far. Just whenever the ball's hit the deck in the Greensboro back half, they've been outstanding and calm.
Oh, that was a free kick given away. Chris Aratus went for a fly in the forward 50. He couldn't take the mark. And I think he might have given away a free kick after that as well.
I reckon he might have hurt himself there, just landing on that hip really heavily. He's back on his feet, but he's certainly sucking in the big breaths.
Matty Hyde, again, knowing what to do in every situation. He's able to deliver to Fowler in the back pocket.
Matty Hyde, of course, coming in with an injury concern. He did miss last week's rep game with, I think it was hamstring tightness. So he, I guess, put the team first, but he's back out there today and he's playing some really good football.
Fowler's delivery was trying to find his teammate in Josh Riddle, but a great mark by Richardson. And now the ball sent back in the Eltham forward half. Well done by Nick Riddle. He read the ball better than Chris Aratus then and got a handball under pressure. Once again, they're doing that all the time here, this Greensboro defence, to Fowler. And Fowler found Josh Riddle.
It's a great mark, isn't it? A diving mark, a slips catch.
And his chip slightly further afield finds Conti. Not a lot further afield. Matty Fowler in a tiny little bit of space, but that's now being closed down. He does find Stanton, who's worked himself towards the boundary. I think he was disguising himself in between the supporters there.
Eltham can't afford to concede another one now, can they? We've gone 25 minutes. They can't afford a deficit of more than 5 goals at half-time.
Stanton's long ball is only as far as Richardson, who takes the mark in the back pocket. They probably don't deserve to be more than this margin down, Eltham, with the effort they've given here in this first half. Greensboro are just so classy when you give them half chances. As Richardson now comes out to the other long sleeve member of this Eltham side, and Darcy Valance, he takes the mark in front of Callaway. And he has Evans further afield, but Stanton is keeping a watchful eye out on him, so he won't go there. He'll go to Burns in a two-on-one, but the kick was centimetre perfect, as Dennis would say, and Burns wheels around. It would have been an opportunity out the back there for Eltham to score again, but the siren went. So that is the end of the second quarter, the end of the first half here in the first game of the 2015.